Think it's all right to touch him?
I was hoping to speak to you.
Is everything all right?
Oh, yes, just, well, as you know, we've been trying to grow fruit down here.
It's good to know that something of the old hideaway still lives on.
Martell's pride and joy. It was a sapling when she rescued it from the rubble, but look at it now. All our hard work's finally paying off. I took it on, you see, after she died, and now the fruit's finally ready to eat. And not only is it ready, it's actually tasty. Sweet as you like, in fact. She bred the bitter right out of it.
Impressive. And welcome news to more than a few, I'd say.
I thought this first harvest could go to the Curse Breakers, on account of all they do for the hideaway. You couldn't take them some, could you? Seems better them coming from you.
It'll be nice being the bearer of good news for a change.
Thank you. She always had a soft spot for that lot, see? And once they've had their share, I'll see to it that everyone else gets some. Here you go. Martell apples, they're called, in honor of her memory. You hear that, Martell? Today's finally the day.
I hear there's trouble in Rosaria.
That broom's as ragged as...
You two look like you could use something to eat. Here, courtesy of Martell.
Martell. Where have I heard that name before?
Weren't she the girl from the Furrows?
Course she was. An odd sort, that one. Loved plants more than people.
Aye, and brave as a bane might. Remember when she ran back into the hideaway to collect them trees when Titan attacked? Wait.
These aren't those apples, are they? Well, I'll be. She'd have been proud, and rightly so. Thank you, Sid.
Others weren't so lucky, though.
Them old apples were enough to curdle your gut. But these beauties are as sweet as you like.
I'll have to pay the boys down in the backyard a visit to tell them thanks.
A gift from the backyard. For your service.
Blimey, these take me back. I haven't seen a hideaway apple since. Old Sid was the only one who could stomach the things. He'd nab them right from the branch, made Martell livid. Not that anyone could stay mad at the man for long.
That sounds like the Sid I knew, all right.
Planning on keeping that lot to yourselves, were you? Hang on. These aren't Martells, are they? I'm glad to see someone carried on what she started. Can't have been easy, not in the Deadlands. Reckon she'd be happy knowing all her hard work didn't go to waste. Clyde, tell the lad down in the backyard to run some over for me, will you?
Not so much as a thank you. Well, I've got some manners at least. Thanks, Sid. You can leave the basket with me. I'll see that the others get their share. Oh, and give our compliments to the gardener, won't you?
That was the last of the apples. I should head to the backyard and pass along everyone's regards.
I hear there's trouble in Rosario.
Breakers send their thanks and their compliments. They were clearly very fond of Martell.
They remembered her after all these years. I suppose she was very kind, even to a tongue-tied lummox like me. You were one of the good ones, Martell. Why did you have to die? She put everything into her work. She wasn't going to rest until we had fruit sweet enough to enjoy. And now we do. When she died, I named a sapling after her. And now it's a full-grown tree. Martell lives on through the fruit it bears.
And through you. Her dream would have died with her, had you not kept it alive. That's something to be proud of.
I didn't do anything, really, but thank you. You're kinder to me than I deserve.
By the way, Otto's expecting some of your crop. And I wouldn't mind some of it either, if that's not too much to ask.
Of course not. I'll see that you're both well provided for. They like your fruit, Martell. Isn't that wonderful? I'd say it's about time we planted you some siblings, don't you think?
I hear there's trouble. Assist you today. Allow me to educate you. Study it well, Clive. Once more? Very well. I have the details here. The state of the realm is ever-changing, Clive.
Clive, welcome to the Patron's Whisper.
The Patron's Whisper? Does that mean someone else is taking care of our friend's donations?
Oh no, that's still me. It's just Karen has her toll, Blackthorn has his hammer. I thought a new name might liven things up. I still catalogue every item that arrives, in addition to setting aside those tokens of appreciation the sender has specified are to be presented to you personally. Would you like to see if we have any? Come to claim your just desserts. You earned this. Here you are. Best of luck out there, Sid.
Fancy a look at the list, do you? Anything catch your eye? Think you can help?
What's the matter, Nectar? The Hunt Board? It's where the Cursebreakers post sightings of particularly fearsome beasts. Those that might pose a threat to our operations if they were left to roam free. Just because they can't be dealt with when they're spotted, doesn't mean they can't be dealt with later. Was that what you wanted to know? Right. Well, leaving your mightiness aside for the moment, the people of Valestia are going through a lot already, what with the Blight and the war. The last thing they need is ungodly fiends terrorizing them on top of everything else. So if the Cursebreakers are too busy to help, then perhaps I can. Or at least I can try.
Do you think it was wise to leave, Gav? He didn't seem pleased.
I needed his eyes and nose in Dalmechia. I'm not about to let Kupka take us unawares. Besides, he has a knack for that sort of thing.
That he does.
And wasn't it Cid who said that matters such as these are best left to Dominant? Especially should one of his beloved opportunities to grow and change present itself.
I always knew that I would return one day. Return to Ironholm.
For what?
After learning the truth, you were given the chance to face your past. If I am to continue at your side, I must do the same.
We will face it together then.
To the end. How far do you think your mother's reach extends? Will we find the same tragedy in the south as we did at Martha's Rest?
More than likely. Which is why we should hurry. There are still many settlements between here and Port Isolde. We visit as many as we can and hear their stories. Starting with the village of Amber.
It's over. Ambrosia.
justice is what it is. Lord Elwyn would never have stood for this.
Quiet, you! Nothing but loyalists.
Jill, look.
Rosaria must be cleansed of the stain which befouls her, that she might rise once again from the ashes to welcome a new dawn. T'would be a pity to make examples of you all for the transgressions of but a handful.
Of course, your lordship. You shall have our full cooperation.
What business could the Black Shields have in a village this small? There's barely room to hide a bearer.
Then they must be here for something else.
You fancy dancing a gallows jig like the miller's son?
All right. I heard you the first time.
You're a long way from home, aren't you? There you are. Sorry, but the shelves are bare. You won't be disappointed. Fare ye well.
Excuse me, but what was all that about earlier?
You haven't heard? Someone's been stirring up trouble. There have been attacks on the garrison, supplies stolen. They even say a Black Shield was murdered. The Empire wants answers, and what the Empire wants, Empire gets.
Don't they just?
Keep your ears open, eh? The Black Shields will pay good coin for information on the culprits. You'd have to be dull as a sack of stones to think you could take on the Empire. What with their 100 full legions?
100? I heard it were 1,000.
We're going hunting for outlaws. How'd you like that, boy?
There was a time my husband might have stood up to those men. Though back then, he wouldn't have needed to.
You seen him, didn't you?
I'm sorry.
The Black Shields, just now. You seen him, didn't you? At least I think there was a Black Shield. Can't say I ever saw one before.
Was this the first time they visited the village?
What do you think? Amber's the arson of nowhere. And they thought we might be harboring firebrands. Huh. If only we were. I might have turned him in and become a Black Shield myself.
You don't think these firebrands the Empire is looking for could be us, do you?
I don't know.
How'd you get it?
But we need to find out.
Greetings, friend. We are travelers.
I know that. What do you want?
We couldn't help noticing those Imperial soldiers who were here earlier.
Don't you go telling these strangers a thing. I speak for the people of this village, and we have nothing more to say to you. You are to leave Amber and never come back.
May I at least ask why?
I don't know who you are or what brings you here, but your presence puts us all in grave danger. The Empire is a harsh master. Its demands are great, and its justice swift. But as long as we keep our heads down and pay our tributes, we are left alone. Some might call it submission. But if it will spare my people the Viceroy's wrath, then I will gladly submit. This village will not become another East Pool.
Then we shall be on our way. These people live with a knife to their throat. In the mistaken belief that if they cooperate, my mother will show them mercy.
Obedience bought with fear.
Are you all right?
Sorry, it's nothing. We still don't know who the Black Shields are looking for.
Well, whoever they are, the Imperials deem them worth pursuing to the back of beyond. But other than Martha, who else in Rosari would have the courage to stand against the Empire? A new ally would certainly be welcome. Can we find them before the Imperials do? Perhaps the next village will yield more answers.
Perhaps.
This pass will take us through the mountains.
And directly into the path of whoever or whatever lurks here.
Ever since the Apollo Tree, we've seen more and more of these echoes.
What do you think is waking them? The Mother Crystal's collapse?
I have an idea. You're not going to like it.
All yours, Torvald!
fight.
Blood, Clive.
And still wet.
You were told to stay in your homes.
The Black Shields.
You know who we are. And still, you would bear your steel. Why then? We owe you our thanks. You have saved us the trouble of an interrogation. To dwell in darkness, that we may purge the night and welcome lasting dawn. On these, our swords we swear.
Say that again.
I'll show you a true shield, Rosario.
Tell me what I want, and the end will be swift. Who are you looking for?
Why, you. We come bearing a message. Your friends have been found. The branded you freed from our camps. They await you in Ordeal. Guardians of the Flame.
Those are Old Hill's gates.
Then we hurry.
Something, boy. Death.
Found her.
This was my mother's doing.
But why? Why would anyone?
I don't know. I never truly understood her. But this...
Oh, Clive.
And I will end it. We should go.
Yes.
We can't leave them here like this.
We won't. But if the Black Shields have made it this far south, they may already be in Port Isolde.
We're approaching Bewick Bridge. Though I doubt the Empire would let us cross over to Rosalith.
I did, Mummy! I could hear him shouting from down the road.
Hush, no! You didn't hear nothing.
They tell us there's a curfew, but then refuse us passage back to our homes.
They're all Rosarian.
But this is their home.
You'll find no succor to the South Travelers, nor beyond the Bewick. The Empire has seen fit to banish us from our own land.
Stay down!
The Lazarus. What happened to this place?
My mother happened. The nobles who lived here didn't stand a chance. Let's hope my uncle fared better. That's the main gate. And it looks like we're not the only ones hoping to get in.
Let us pass!
My children are starving!
Have mercy!
Chance of slipping through unnoticed. We'll need to find another way in. I thought we might be able to reason with the guards. Or at least bribe them.
I suspect everyone in that crowd thought the same. Was that the only way in?
Officially, yes. Strictly speaking, no. My uncle once told me that the nobles had tunnels built so that they could visit town without having to walk amongst the rabble. The Lazarus. We'll find our way into the city there.
If you're sure. The entire place looked abandoned. Do you think it's safe?
As long as it is abandoned.
The good news is we haven't seen a single Black Shield since Oldhill.
Maybe they found who they were looking for.
I hear there's trouble in Rosaria.
Think it's all right to touch him? Thank you.
So Mather's all right.
Yep. Others weren't so lucky. Pooja's nice and chilled.
Look at this place.
We spend half.
This isn't going to be easy.
room's as ragged as...
So Mather's all right.
Ready, go? Run like the wind.
This might take a while. You deserve a rest.
ragged as...
So Mather's all right.
Yep. Others weren't so lucky, though.
Welcome to the Patron's Whisper. Is everything we've received and everything promised? You earned this. Come again. I may have more for you.